It's showtime.
Hey, welcome to Did You Watch Survivor Last Night? My name is Jake Shidell. This is a podcast about reality television and friendship in which I ask my best friend, Thomas Powell, if he did indeed watch a certain reality show. Hey, Thomas, how you doing today?
Jake, I'm feeling pretty good. You know what song I've had stuck in my head since last night?
The Joker's theme song.
And Twins.
Why is that stuck in your head?
Your boy just saw Gemini Man, and yeah, I'm feeling like I'm seeing double. Two Will Smiths.
Is it good?
I'm seeing double. Four Will Smiths.
Okay.
Classic Simpsons line. It's not good, but it's bad in the way that I wanted it to be bad, and that is
good.
Even better than it being good. I think I would have been disappointed if it was just a kind of good movie. It's dumb. The writing is pretty bad. It's competently directed because Ang Lee directed it. Remember how Ang Lee directed Brokeback Mountain, which is like one of the best movies of the 2000s? And then now he's making Gemini Man.
Yeah, didn't he also do Life of Pi?
He did do Life of Pi.
He's got
and Crouching
a weird
Tiger,
career.
Hidden Dragon. But he also did the Hulk. Eric Bana Hulk movie.
Yes.
Which is similarly dumb, but is also interestingly directed.
Yeah.
I would recommend that anyone go see it. It's almost like if... Are you familiar with the Tim Heidecker show, Decker?
Not super familiar, no.
Okay, it's basically Tim Heidecker making a count... Like, if Tim Heidecker made Homeland... The character Tim Heidecker.
Oh, yeah.
It's the On Cinema character, Tim Heidecker's show that he made.
Okay.
And so it's like really dumb, but it involves espionage. And this is like if they got someone to punch up a Decker script a little bit.
A little bit.
The best part of it is that they don't say the CIA in it. They say the DIA. It's like the Department of Internal Affairs or whatever.
Oh, I was going to say the Drug Enforcement Agency.
No, that's not even what that stands for, but Department of Intelligence Affairs or something like that. But
okay.
But yeah, and also there's a scene in it where clone Will Smith uses dirt bike kata to to like kick someone in the face with the front of the tire.
Good.
It's great. And then also there is a reveal at the end of it that is maybe the dumbest thing that I've ever seen in a movie. And
Will Smith
was
Joseph Gordon-Levitt the whole time. Is that
no
it? It was Bruce Willis the whole time?
Let's just say that if you think there's only two Will Smiths in the movie, you may be mistaken.
Morrissey comes around the corner. Am I getting
also
close?
Clive Owen's the bad guy in it, and he does one of those American accents where like it's technically good, but also it's like it's Clive Owen, like I know he's doing an accent, and then towards the end of the movie he just kind of stops doing it.
Oh, that's fun. I love when
it's
that
great.
Happens.
I was on board. I want Clive Owen to have Clive Owen's voice, not American Clive Owen's voice. Also, there is a bunch of really bad product placement in it, in like the best, most obvious way possible, because there's a character in the movie who is a recovering alcoholic, and so Will Smith, on two different occasions, brings him a can of Coca-Cola, and it's like center frame. With the logo facing it, it's like.
Does Will Smith
drinking,
say it's a hot one?
You're drinking
soda
from now on. And it's just like I'm going to set this Coca-Cola down. There's also there's also a scene where they're hiding out like in like a store of it's like a corner shop basically, and being shot at. And, like, right where they're holed up, there's several cases of Bud Light.
Love it.
Will Smith. And,
okay.
My favorite of all of them is as they get ambushed coming into this town. And in the town, the rest of it is, like kind of normal. It just looks like kind of like a smaller town. But there is a big sign, like a storefront sign for H&R Block. I was like, we got to stop here, Benedict Wong. I have to do my taxes.
So... It's a clone movie? I thought it was a time travel movie.
It is not. It is a movie where Will Smith is retiring. He is a CIA contracted sniper who, does hits on people.
Yeah.
Sorry, DIA.
Yeah.
But he decides to retire And then he finds out that the last guy that he killed, they spiked his file, and it turns out he wasn't a terrorist. He was actually a former employee of, he was a molecular biologist, and he was part of the Gemini program.
Ugh, yeah. I'm so tired of it already.
Yeah, and so he finds that out, and then Clive Owen tries to burn him. And also, Mary Elizabeth Winstead is like a DIA agent who is tailing him in his retirement, and he figures her out really quickly. And so she has to go with him because they're going to kill her, too. And yeah, then, you know, they run away, and then clone Will Smith gets sent after him, and he's younger Will Smith. And this sometimes it looks, sometimes the CGI looks very good, and then sometimes, but like the eyes always look a little bit off. And then towards the end of the movie, there's a scene where young Will Smith is going back to us. He, you know, he's going to get the civilian life that he never had. So he's going to college, and they're in an outdoor like quad area where they can't control any of the lighting. And he looks like shit. He looks so bad, and he looked pretty good for most of the movie. And then the last scene of the movie, he looks like fucking Polar Express shit. He looks like smooth Patrick Stewart from the end of X-Men Origins Wolverine, if you've ever seen that before.
Mm-hmm.
It's horrifying. yeah, he looks fucking terrible. It's great. I was so distracting. I was like, why does he look like that? They did this semi-convincingly for the entire movie. They must have run out of budget.
Just at the very end, I'm sure they filmed it in chronological
order. Our mutual friend Preston and I were joking that it was like, there are multiple instances of famous anime series that they just ran out of money by the end of it. Like, mm-hmm. they blew their whole animation budget and were like, shit, we gotta finish this. And so there's been instances where the last scenes in an episode of one is just like all still frame, like black and white drawings, because they didn't have the money to do anything else.
That's like old episodes of Doctor Who that they just like forgot to save, so they just recreate it with like thumbnails.
Yeah,
and then they still have the audio.
The best instance of that is because it is the end to like one of the most famous animes of all time, is Neon Genesis Evangelion, because it has a famously unsatisfying, stupid ending, and it's because they just didn't have the money to do the real one.
I thought that show was, like, really well regarded.
People do really like that show, but the ending is famously, like, you know, like, that's not really what you're there for. That's like, if you've ever seen that, that's the one where it's just every character going, congratulations.
Okay. I have not seen that show, although
I've seen some of it, and it's pretty good, but I didn't finish it.
Yeah, I've been meaning to watch it. You know what show I do really like? A show called Survivor. Thomas, did you watch Survivor Island of the Idols last night?
I grew up on that cash money. Bling Bling was well known to flash money.
Speaking of two things, yes, I did.
What do you mean by
There's
that?
There's two people on the Island of the Idols. Sandra and younger clone of Sandra.
That would be so good. What if the two idols were Survivor Pearl Islands, Sandra and Survivor Heroes versus Villains?
Survivor Gemini Sandra. Man, the only player that can take out Sandra is younger Sandra.
Oh man, next time we have an off week, let's do a Gemini Man where we just do the younger versus the older version of, like, 10 people.
Gemini Man is the perfect title for a movie because it's extremely fun to say, and it's also the title of a movie that would never be good.
Why don't they call it Gemini?
It's like a movie that...
Gemini.
It's like a movie that Donald Kaufman would write.
Yeah. We were just talking about Charlie Kaufman before we started recording.
His fake twin brother from Adaptation would write a movie called Gemini Man.
You know, I watched Adaptation for the first time in a long time in the last couple of years. It is not as good as I remember.
I don't know, man. I like that movie a lot.
I really liked it, but I remember liking it a lot more in high school.
Yeah.
Which is,
I mean, that's true about a lot of things.
True. You're not wrong. Okay, this episode of Survivor was called Honesty Would Be Chill. I like it. Are the two Will Smiths honest with each other in Gemini Man?
One of them is, but the other one needs to be honest with himself.
Oh, man, that's so deep. That's that good Ang Lee shit that all those movies are about.
You know who wrote that, by the way? I think there was another co-writer, but David Benioff of Game of Thrones showrunner fame.
Oh. For Gemini Man?
Yeah, which is probably why it sucked, because he had to write his own material again.
What did you think of this episode title?
Honesty Would Be Chill is pretty good.
Honesty Would Be Chill. I like it a lot. I think it's the best one they've done so far in the whole show. Or this season, at least, is what I'm saying. I'm making jokes. Okay, Vokai. Nobody wants to talk after the vote time. He explains that Molly was a threat, and then he calls himself the wild card. So, Tommy, that's my guy. Not your guy. You didn't pick Tommy, but I did. Just saying. He's a wild card now. Look out. Dan, he should look out because of Tommy. You were nervous, Thomas, about my boy Tommy?
No, I'm not worried about him because Dan's a strong player, and you know, I think he can handle himself.
I don't know. We'll see. Okay, over on Lyro, Karishma is starting to believe that the Women's Alliance is a ruse. Aaron is worried that there is a Women's Alliance and brings Vince into the Men's Alliance. Man, what an episode for Vince. Over on Vokai,
what an episode indeed.
Yeah. Over on Vokai, Dan still wants Nora out. Jamal considers going rogue and targets Dan, and then Janet and Tommy hear him out. Not looking so good for your boy Dan over there, Thomas.
Yeah, well, you know.
Tommy seems to be good friends with everybody. Dan over here. Jamal doesn't like him. Kelly doesn't like him. The other people don't like him.
I mean, we'll see.
Great pick, though. Great pick. Back over on Lyro.
I mean, only one of our picks was at risk for getting voted off this episode. Mm. So maybe you should worry about your own picks.
I mean, I know how the episode ends, and I'm not worried, but...
I mean, maybe you should be, though.
Yeah, here's the thing, though. I'm not, because I have a really good pick. I have two really good picks, actually, and yours are okay. Like, Elaine? What? She was barely in this episode. Dan? He got targeted, and they didn't even go to Tribal Council. Like, that's not a good look. I'm just saying. As far as points go, you might have more than me, but mine are, like, more substantial, the points I do have, so... Just saying, look out, because I'm coming for your crown. On Lyro, Karishma cuts her hand with a machete, then gets upset that no one came to help her, which I think is a fair issue to have with your tribe when everybody's trying to be friendly.
Sure.
In an exit interview, Vince's reason he said for not coming up to help her was that he doesn't like seeing people he cares about hurt. It's like... Yeah, duh. Like, who likes that?
I love it when people close to me are hurt, personally. Like,
I didn't want to see it.
It's actually very good to me.
Oh, Vince. He is then chosen to go to the Island of the Idols. The tribe wants to flush that idol once he comes back, so Dean suggests that they split the vote while literally the entire tribe is standing there. So Karishma assumes that they'll be splitting the vote with her. You know, you're always like, oh, you should be worried that Karishma's going home. But she seemed, like, fairly aware of what was going on the whole time. So I'm just...
I think that you're trying to spin this in your own favor. That's what it sounds like to me.
Well, we'll see in 10 weeks when the season is over who's winning. And it's going to be me. On the Island of the Idols, Vince starts crying after Rob asks him where he's from. And then Boston Rob says, you don't know where you're from.
Oh, that was great.
It was very funny. His lesson is how to be calm under pressure. So he has to go to the other camp and steal their fire. Which is a wild thing
that
he
forced
to do.
That is a crazy challenge.
Like, nobody else had to do anything that difficult. But it rained, so their fire went out. So he just had to collect some ash. And Boston Rob says that's good enough and gives him an idol for the next two tribal councils.
Had to collect some ass.
Ass, grass, or cash, nobody gets for free.
Nobody gets an idol for free.
Yeah. Oh, what you opening up there, Tanis?
Jake, take a guess.
Is it a bubbly?
No.
Is it an uptime?
It is. That's... Jake, you know that's not what it sounds like when you open an uptime.
Well, I don't know. We're over the phone.
They don't have cans of uptime.
Not yet. Not yet.
It is also not. It is not a little bit of the bubbly.
Hmm. I'm gonna guess it's a can. Okay. Is it a Pepsi Cola?
No, idiot. It's a fucking Coca-Cola Zero, which is what I'm always drinking when we do this.
Oh, you say always.
We've done this, like, there have been, like, the last, like, three beverage checks have been me being like, yeah, it's Coke Zero.
Beverage checks. Are we calling it beverage checks now? It's bottle check. It's bottle check, even when it's a can. Come on. Beverage check. There's no ring to beverage
I'm
check.
I'm consistent with my bottle checks. I feel like you always just have a different energy drink every time.
That's true, I do.
I like that you try every single energy drink that you see. Every time I see a new one, I'm like, eh, I'm wary of this.
Oh, no, I have the exact same reaction, but I'm also like, what if it is good, though?
And it's good, right, like, now I'm drinking Quake Berry Blast. Most of the time, they're terrible.
Quake Berry Blast, it's fine. It's already open, so I'm drinking it. I had a naked smoothie earlier, the blue one, because I was feeling a little bummed out. So I drank it, and now I'm in
a better
mood. You were
feeling blue? Feeling like a blue machine?
That's why they made it blue. It's actually the blueberries.
Chase away the blues.
Chase away the blueberries. That's what their tagline should be. Okay. The Berry Blast, or whatever the fuck this one's called. Yeah, Berry Blast. It's also in a blue can, because berries, they're blue. Okay. That's Bottle Check, everyone's favorite segment. Let's get talk about this immunity challenge. They have to grab a key and then balance on a big balance beam and then grab some puzzle pieces and then do a puzzle and Vokai wins. Congratulations to Vokai. It's a great challenge. It was actually a really cool challenge. The big balance beam was cool. It's cool. They haven't done this before, and that's always good to see. You love to see it. Don't you love to see it,
Truly you
it,
do.
Thomas? Okay. Okay, back on Lyro. They target Vince and Karishma, but then Missy targets Tom. Were you worried, Thomas, when Missy said your own name? Were you like, oh no, am
they're
going to
vote me
out?
Off. They're going to make it so I can't watch the show anymore.
Karishma is still worried that it's her, but Vince convinces her to vote for Tom. Eh?
I enjoyed this segment because Vince had the exact reaction I would have, which is when someone is just talking to you about strategy, but they will only say it in the vaguest possible way, and he's like, just fucking tell me a name. I don't have time for this.
It's probably because she was targeting Vince, but didn't want to let him know. Classic Survivor move from future winner Karishma. Don't know her last name. Okay, Thomas, it's about time for some wildlife shots. We got crab, we've got birds, we've got an egret or heron type bird, didn't look it up, but we also got a golden silk orb weaver, pretty cool spider. They're also called the golden orb weavers, giant wood spiders, or banana spiders.
Banana spiders are pretty poisonous, aren't they?
They are not. Well, they have venom, but only to take out prey. If they bite a human, there's like little to no effect at all.
Interesting.
Yeah. They belong to the Nephiwa genus. Don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but in Greek it means fond of spinning. Which is just a great name,
yeah.
I think.
I mean, it's a very accurate description. They love the spinning. They can't get enough of it.
Truly. They range in color from a reddish to a green-yellow with a white back and striped legs. Female bodies can be 1.5 to 2 inches wide, while the males are significantly smaller. They can be found all throughout the world because the spiderlings float through the air and can float for a very long time. Even, like, to New Zealand, where they don't... Or not endemic, I think was the word used. But they just, like, floated there from Australia, I guess. It's cool. Spiders are cool, even though they're creepy. Hey, it's Halloween. That's why we're doing spiders. All spiders all month, except for last week when we talked about something else. Do you remember last week's wildlife shot?
No.
I don't think it was a spider.
I don't care to.
Happy Halloween, everybody. Their webs can be as wide as 5 feet, and the silk is yellow, which is where they get the golden orb weaver name. And I mentioned already that they have venom to kill their prey, but it has little to no effect on humans. So that's the golden orb weaver. Pretty cool stuff. Love it. At Tribal Council, Tom and Aaron blame their loss on Karishma for not getting the puzzle done. Karishma argues for herself. Tom says that his motivation is to win. You said you liked this, Thomas. Do you relate to Tom, since you guys have the same name? Who do you like more, Tom or Tommy?
Not really. Other than being kind of competitive, I don't really relate to him in any other way. He seems cool, though. He seems like a guy that I would get along with.
Good dad type.
Yeah. I could see him being like a tribal father figure.
Mm-hmm. Do you like Tommy more? Do you relate more to him?
I will never relate to anyone named Tommy. To anyone who would willingly use that nickname.
Do you think he came in and was like, "Hey, I'm Tom," and they were like, "We've already got a Tom.
We've already got one of those. You're going to have to do something else."
Mm-hmm.
I actually, if that were the case, I would relate to that because when I worked at Jimmy John's, there were three
Jimmy Toms.
Toms, yeah, and so I had to go by Thomas because, which I was fine with, but like,
yeah,
because we, even, it was the owner of the store, his name was Tom, and he went by TK, and then the other Tom, would go by, Hutch, because it was, part of his last name.
Okay, that makes sense. And he went by Thomas because that's your name.
That's true.
I know that. Don't think I don't know that. What's his name? Jeff. Jeff tells them it's time to vote, but Karishma says wait, and then gets up and starts whispering to a bunch of people. Then they vote. Tom, your dad gets one vote. Karishma gets a vote. Karishma gets another vote. Karishma gets three votes, and then Vince gets 5 votes. So Vince goes home with an idol in his pocket. Hall of Shame.
Rough. It's rough whenever that happens.
It's really embarrassing, especially when there's like an expiration date on your immunity idol. Not a great look, Vince. An idol in your pocket, and you come back for your future season, I think you should still be allowed to use that idol.
That would rule, actually.
But it's like so ineffective because everyone knows you have it.
Yeah, I suppose that's true.
You better use it at the first one. Otherwise, you're getting voted out. All right, Thomas, you want to talk about these points since you're so confident about how many points you want?
I love talking about how many points I win.
You want a point for Vokai winning the reward, as well as the immunity. You got a point for Dan surviving, Elaine surviving, and another point for Vince going home. Pretty good week for you. You got 11 points now. I got a point for Vokai winning reward. I got a point for Tommy surviving and Karishma and Vince going to Island of the Islands. And that makes me have 9 points.
Island of the Islands.
Yep, that's what it's called now. So it's the score is now 9 to 11. Just saying. Are you feeling pretty good about your chances now?
I'm always feeling good about all of my chances.
It's good. Good for you. Do you want to hear what my mom thinks about Survivor this week?
I would love to hear what your mom thinks.
She says, Vince got overconfident. He should have played his idol. But I'm glad he didn't because that means Karishma is still there. It made me mad that no one helped her when she cut her hand. Editing? But why did she take on the puzzle role in the challenge if she knows she's not good at puzzles? Those are my only thoughts for now. Fantastic. That's my mom's thoughts. The end. Here's what's happening on... Oh, wait. We didn't pick people points for next week, did we yet?
I don't believe so.
No, we did not. Who's winning the reward challenge? Vokai won last week, so you get a point for that. Who's winning this week?
Me. I'm winning.
Oh, okay. You have to pick a tribe first before you do that.
Well, I'm just saying
you don't just
I'm
get
just
the point
I'm gonna
because
win.
You say you I mean, you might, but you gotta make a choice first before you can officially win. Yeah, you're like Wreck-It Ralph, but winning. Who's winning a reward challenge, Thomas? Are you just not gonna put a prediction in? Because well, that's your choice. You can do that.
I guess.
I think it's a bad move.
I guess. Oh boy, man, we have fun here.
We really do. Don't forget to brush your teeth, though.
Yes. Yeah. Eat vitamins. Say your prayers. Drink your milk. Yeah, I guess I will say that. What's the not Vokai one?
Lyro.
I'm going to say that Lyro wins reward and immunity.
Okay. That makes sense because they're going back and forth.
Yeah.
Just for sake of picking something different from you, I'm going to pick Vokai because now they voted off Vince and so they're like a stronger team now. Does that mean Lyro goes back to immunity or tribal council? God damn it. We've been doing this show for 4 years. How do I not remember what anything is called? You said Lyro for both?
Yes.
I'm going to say Vokai for both. I don't know who's on what tribe anymore. Reward, what will the reward be?
I'm going to say the reward is hamburgers.
I'm going to say it's hamburger helper. Just kidding. I'm going to say it's fishing gear again. Both your people are still in. Who's going to Island of the Idols? It's going to be somebody from Lyro. Do you want me to pull up the list of people? So you can be reminded who all is on that tribe.
I'm going to say that Tom goes to Island of the Idols.
Tom Laidlaw. All right. I'm going to say Missy. Who will be voted out then?
I'm going to say... what's her name? You know, the annoying one.
Nora?
Yes.
I'm going to say Dean. Did you remember there's somebody named Dean on this season?
I do. I even know who you're talking about.
Nice. You know, you might not like him at the beginning, but he's really going to grow on you.
Oh, yeah. I've heard about it. I remember someone telling me that. It was him.
Okay, here's what happened on the challenge. Team USA won yet another challenge. The thing is, the USA team is all, like, challenge finalists and champions. And the UK team has, like, 3 finalists ever on it, and then a whole bunch of rookies. So, like, of course the USA team is winning a bunch.
Yeah, that's rough.
Yeah. So the UK team sent in Bear and Joss to elimination. It was Hall Brawl, but there were multiple walls that they had to run down before clashing. Very exciting stuff. Joss won, and that's what happened on the challenge. Here's the thing. I've mentioned this before. They bumped it up to 90 minutes now, which is great, except for the fact that nothing ever happens on this show. Like, we don't need this show to be 90 minutes long.
No, there's absolutely no reason that show should ever be 90 minutes long.
There's not enough subplots or character development or anything. It's boring to be that long, but whatever. I don't run MTV. Not yet, anyway.
Not yet. They haven't decided to let you do that yet.
I don't know why. I've got some good ideas. Idea 1, bring Next back.
Got some.
Idea 2, from 1 a.m. to 8 a.m., just play Gemini Man.
Yeah.
Constantly.
I love it. You've already, yeah. I would be giving you a giant check for $1 million.
Fantastic. Mondays? Monday nights, though? No Gemini Man. Instead, it's Matrix Mondays. So we play all 3 Matrix movies in a row every Monday night.
I love it.
Matrix Mondays on MTV.
Mm-hmm. Matrix Television.
I think it's a great idea. So who's the head of MTV right now? I'm going to tell them to email me. Head of MTV. I want my MTV. Like, literally. MTV. Okay, where's the name? Robert Pittman. Is he still? He's the founder. This is very interesting. How old do you think MTV is?
I think it was like right around 1980, so almost 40 years old?
It is 38 years old.
Yep.
Robert Pittman.
Sounds about right.
65. Why is a 65-year-old in charge of MTV? It should be me. I'm not even 30 yet. Soon, though. Pretty soon.
Can't believe that MTV is run by a fucking boomer who's twice as old as us. Unbelievable.
Right? That's ridiculous. Let me do it.
Yeah, come on.
Whatever. Use the hashtag #YazQueen. Yo, Sandra.
Or don't.
Okay, do you have a better suggestion for a hashtag?
Hashtag.
Yeah, okay. I think you think that's funny because, oh, now I have to bleep something out. But here's the thing. You already said something earlier in the episode that we are bleeping out. That's not that man's name. And I think you forgot that it's a bleeped out phrase. So...
Did I say a...
You did... Oh, god damn it.
I'm trying to remember our bleep phrases. Did I say his name?
Nope.
I don't want him. I don't want him. You know, putting IG Insta. You know, IG story updates talking about us on there.
Would be a great. What the fuck else was bleeped? You're gonna have to listen and find out.
No, because I won't listen.
Let me double check. Censored from a show. Yep, it's there's one other thing that we have bleeped out that you have not said yet.
Gemini Man?
No, why would I ever bleep out Gemini Man? Everyone's favorite movie.
It's a great title for a movie.
Gemini Man is really this generation's Joker.
Yeah, it's in many ways.
Is Gemini an astrological sign?
Yes, it is. It is. They are the twins.
Oh, because there's two of them or more, from what I've heard. I heard a rumor there's more than two Will Smiths.
There's a third one. Who can say?
Who's to say? Okay, well, this is the year of Sandra. You know how it works. All the seasons that she's on, except for the one that was bad. You could follow us on Twitter at DYWSLN. You could follow me at Jake Shadell Thomas. What's your Twitter handle?
At Tom Not Tom.
You should change it to Tom Not Tom Laidlaw.
That'd be pretty funny. I probably won't do that, though.
Yeah, well, you could if you wanted to.
I could, but that doesn't mean that I will.
Okay. Well, that's up to you. That's your decision. It's your life. I'm not going to tell you what to do.
Yeah, I don't care what you say anymore. This is my life. Billy Joel.
Love that guy. What should people write to review this show on whatever platform they get it on?
I like this. This is my favorite podcast. I like it better than all the other podcasts. I gave it a big thumbs up.
How many stars?
5 stars, please.
Assuming that's the max number of stars. If it's a 10-star system...
Yeah, if there are more stars that you can give, please give us the max number of stars. But yeah. I don't think you can give more than... don't think you can give more than 5, so...
If it were possible, though, I would give this podcast
just more importantly, I mean, the 5 stars is very important, or whatever the max number of stars is, but the big thumbs up is extremely important.
Oh, yeah, that's really what iTunes is looking for when they promote podcasts on their homepage. Anyway, have a great summer.
Deuces.
Sandra sings a bird song. Fly so much, her wings are strong. Take the sky down from the flyer. Let her down and my fun is gone. All the junkies left to cry. All the junkies wave goodbye. Laugh and cry. Heavy to lie. When the earth dies, we wish we'd died. Need to find my Latin lover. To find my powdered wig. When the police tear us into, I'll wear the custom, I'll dress in it. All the jailbirds left to cry, all the jailbirds say goodbye, laugh and cry, heavy to lie. When the earth dies, we wish we died.
Glad to hear it.